YouTube, what's going on? Kyle again from ePoolSupply. Today we are back with a installation video on the brand new IntelliFlo3 VSF. We're going to show you guys how to put the I/O board in. Stay tuned. All right, guys, and we're back. So again, today we've got the brand new IntelliFlo3. This is the VSF, brand new pump, just hit the market, just released. So a lot of people are not gonna be very familiar with this thing. If you guys wanna see some more information about it, check out the links in the description. We've got a what's in the box for you guys, and then we've got a comparison video compared to an original IntelliFlo3 horsepower pump. So we can kind of show you guys what the difference is and what some of the comparisons are between those. But for today's video, I wanna go over installing the I/O board on this pump. So they make two different versions of this pump. The model number we're looking at right now is an 011076. That is the one that is going to come with the I/O board. And then they have an 011075 that will not come with the I/O board. So the I/O board is basically an additional hookup to allow you guys to add items for automation directly to the pump. So for those of you guys that aren't too familiar, they sell something that they call like an IntelliConnect, where it's a very basic automation system that you can kind of put out, hook up a few items to it, including a pump, and be able to connect to your app and then be able to have automation on the go wherever you guys are, whether it's an Airbnb or, you know, you just want to make sure that you get that pump turned on before the storm's coming, or, you know, you're going to be coming home. You want to flip that pump on, get that water moving so that you guys can jump in the pool when you get home. So this new pump will allow you to do that directly through the pump itself. So it's got a nice little sticker here on top that's got a QR code, shows you guys how to actually download the Pentair app, get set up, and then it will actually walk you guys through how to completely set up the pump once you guys actually get the power hooked up and everything installed. So again, highly suggest you contact a pool professional before you guys just buy this from a brick and mortar store and try to throw this in your pool. It does have specific requirements that you guys need to have. So if you don't, it's going to require a lot of revamping, renovation of your actual equipment. So again, make sure you source that out before you guys try to do this on your own. We will have a video of showing you guys how to get this installed out in the field and kind of show you guys those things. But right now, I just want to show you guys how to install that I/O board inside the pump itself. So they ship it separately, direct from Pentair. You guys will see that in my What's in the Box. It comes in this nice little white box in the pump. The entire reason for shipping it separately, one is it is an electronic board. So it's wrapped up in here in a nice anti-static bubble bag. And then two, they want to make sure that it's not already pre-installed on the pump. And in shipping from them to us, something gets damaged and breaks. So they make sure that they pack that separately so that you guys make sure it gets to you safely. So what we're going to be looking at here is you're going to focus on the two Phillips head screws right here located on the back end of the pump. So we're going to go ahead and use our handy dandy little screwdriver and just loosen these bad boys up. Oh, my help is in the right direction. So again, only these two screws. If you guys are focused on these four screws on top, you're gonna pull this board off. There's not really much underneath it. Don't suggest doing it. It was very difficult to get back on. I did it, so I'm telling you guys, if you do not have a reason to get into these four screws, don't do it. When you're looking for power hookup and you're looking for the installation of the I/O board, you are focusing on these back two screws. So go ahead and completely remove them. And don't use power tools. Grab a regular screwdriver, really simple. These are not large screws. Last thing you guys wanna do is break this nice, pretty expensive pump by over-tightening anything. So go ahead and loosen them, and you guys will see that this flap just actually lifts up and slides off. So again, I'm gonna switch over to this camera so you guys can see it. You'll see that here's all your hookups, here's all your punch outs for your additional items, for additional power, whatever it may be. They've got the one center already punched out for you because obviously you need to have one for your main power hookup. This is a 208 or a 230 voltage pump, so you cannot hook this up whatsoever to a 115, 120, so do not try to do that. It is meant for the 208 or 230, so you guys definitely need to have a higher voltage. So you're going to go ahead and run that up. They've already given you the punch out here to be able to wire that in. And then the main area that we're focusing on is over here on this side, which is where we'll go ahead and install the I/O board. So I'll go ahead and open this up. Again, it's got little instructions in here, a little bit more information about the I/O board. I've already taken it out of its anti-static bag. So again, if you guys, when you get it, it's gonna still be in the bag. Be gentle, this is an actual board, computer board. So dry hands, make sure you guys touch something, don't be static. Right here, they've got a nice little sticker on here with the relay contacts and ratings telling you guys that this does not have any sort of GFI. So if you are powering it up, make sure that you have a GFI breaker. If not, make sure your sub panel has a GFI breaker so that if anything happens, you don't fry this thing. Because that would, again, last thing you guys want to do. We sell surge protectors. We sell all those things. We'll have those available for you guys in the links in the description that you guys can wire in with this to make sure that you don't actually fry this. Because when you're going to spend this much money and this much time on this piece of equipment, you'll want to make sure you do it right. So again, if you are unsure of how to install it, please contact your pool professional. They will have more information on these items as they are directly trained from Pentair professionals. So highly suggest doing that. But here's our actual I/O board. You guys will see it's got relay hookups. It's got low voltage, high voltage stuff. It's got all different kinds of lines. Again, we'll get into an actual video of actually hooking stuff up so you can see what needs to go where in terms of your devices. But for today, I just want to get this piece installed on its own. So you'll notice right here on the actual plastic piece like we were talking about, you'll have a screw hole, which is going to be the screw hole meant for the I/O board. It's already actually pre-screwed here on the I/O board. And then you'll notice the back end has a horizontal plug here that we're going to go ahead and push into this slot on the pump. So you just kind of, it's kind of meant to be. It's already got its own little area here. So you're just going to kind of gently wiggle that thing in and just get it so that you're lined up to where you can actually start to anchor down the screw into the pump itself. So again, hand tools only, guys. Don't try to get fancy. Do not try to do this with a drill. The last thing you want to do is snap this board and cause your you and your client a lot more headaches. So make sure that you guys are using a regular screwdriver. Really easy. So hand tight, don't over tighten it. Just kind of focus on it. You guys can tell I saw as the board sank down here with the screw. So now everything is completely hooked up. And now from here, you can actually start hooking up all your other devices. So again, we're going to dive into that for you guys, but really, really cool that it shows you guys all these different punch outs so that you guys actually have a full electrical box already kind of set up on the back end of the pump. So really, really nifty. And again, they give you a whole little color code here on what the lights will mean on your touchpad when you're trying to connect, when you're turning it on and off, or when you're actually running it into a quick clean mode for those service professionals out there. So really simple to get this back onto. It just kind of sits on there. There's no special way to put it on, unlike this other center one that I took off earlier. But just wanted to show you guys how to get that I/O board installed. Once you guys get everything hooked up, you're gonna just make sure you sync everything back down. Again, hand tight and weatherproof everything so that everything is nice and dry, because we all know that electricity and water don't mix. So again, want to show you guys how to install the new I/O board on the brand new IntelliFlo3 VSF. Check out all the links in the description. We've got other videos available for you guys. Visit the website. We've got a ton of information, blogs, everything available for you guys if you guys want more questions or more information on this item. So I really appreciate you guys watching. And until next time, I'm Kyle from ePoolSupply.